Welcome once again. This is your host, Prophetess Dr. Christine Ziggy. Welcome you. From Overcomers Deliverance and Healing Ministry, Brampton, Ontario, Canada. Welcome. Welcome. The topic I'm going to talk to you is called Crushing the Instrument of the Wickedness. Crushing the Instrument of the Wickedness. And I'm going to read from the book of 2 Kings 6, 15 to 19. 2 Kings 6, 15 to 19. The Bible says, When the servant of a man of God rose early in the morning and went out, a servant of the man rose up early in the morning, wake up early in the morning, and they went out. When the servant of the man of God, the servant of Elijah, wake up early in the morning, he went out. When he went out, the Bible says, behold, an army with the host and a chariot was all around the city. And the servant said, arise, my master, what shall we do? He said, do not be afraid, for those who are with us are more than those who are with them. Then Elisha prayed and said, O Lord, please open his eyes that he may see. So the Lord opened the eyes of the young man, and he saw, and behold, the mountains was full of horses and chariots of fire all around Elisha. And when the Syrians came down against him, Elisha prayed to the Lord and said, please strike these people with blindness. So he struck them with blindness in according with the prayer of Elisha. And Elisha said to them, this is not the way. This is not the city. Follow me, and I will bring you to the man whom you seek. And he lead them to Samaria. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise the name of Jesus. Now, the young man, the servant of Elisha, he woke up early in the morning, and he saw the chariot and host around the city. Now he was afraid. He didn't know what to do. He rushed in the house and called his master. Tell master, we are dying. Something is not good here. All the armies of Syrians have invited this place. They are going to kill us. They are going to destroy us. And then Elisha, he didn't worry, because he understood how he's going to crush their weapon, how he's going to crush their instrument, how he's going to destroy them. He didn't worry about anything. He told the young man, please don't worry, don't be afraid. I'm going to ask God to open your eyes, and you will see the angels we have than them they had there. The man of God prayed for the young man, and the young man, his eyes opened, and they saw thousands, millions and millions of angels and horses surrounding them. I pray that let your eyes to open and see the angels are around you, and you are not going to be afraid, because you will target, you will destroy every instrument of the wicked, every instrument of the enemy. If Elisha did know how to destroy their weapon, they could have killed them. They could have destroyed the whole city. Now, Elisha, he was very smart. He prayed, he said, God, blind them. Blind them. He destroyed their weapon by blinding them. Now their weapon become useless. Even if you have nuclear bomb, even if you have any weapon that you have, any instrument that you can use, when you are blind, you can't use it. You cannot see to operate. Now these people, all of them became blind. And then Elisha told them, okay, I'm going to show you the person you are looking for. And then Elisha led them back to Samaria. He confused them. He took them to the wrong places. This is what your enemy, this is what you can deal with the enemy. Every enemy, all the weapon they are using, all the instrument they are using, they will go blind and they will be wasted, and you will get all of them. Elisha was leading the enemy. You know, when you are leading the enemy, you can do them anything you want because you have already roost their power. You have weakened everything they have. You have destroyed their weapon. You have destroyed their instrument. They have no power because they can't see. They have no power. If American army go to war, Afghanistan, Pakistan, Africa, wherever they go, with their jetty, with all the instrument they have, and then all the armies, they go blind. Who is going to ride them? Who is going to drive? Who is going to fight? Nobody. And then you can take them, you can do anything you want because they can't see, they are blind. That is how you can crush the enemy. You can crush the enemy by using blindness. Blindness is a best weapon, is a best instrument that you can use to blind all the instrument of the wicked, all the instrument of the enemy in the mighty name of Jesus. Now, I thank God because Elisha prayed to God and they said, please strike these people with blindness. Elisha prayed to God and God responded and blinded them. You will blind every enemy. You will crush their weapon, enemy, witchcraft, wherever they are using, any method they are using, they will go blind. If a witchcraft go blind, they can't operate. They can't do anything. Therefore, I pray the instrument of the blindness let strike to your enemies in the mighty name of Jesus. I pray that God, who blinded the Syrians, who were following the children of Israel, let them fall upon you. The Syrians were the enemies. They were the weakest people. They were witchcraft. They were evil people who were following the children of Israel, wanted to destroy them. Now, Elisha has to attack them in a very high level. He attacked their instrument. He attacked the weapon they were using. He attacked them by blinding them. Hallelujah. Praised be the name of Jesus. Let's look in the book of Revelation. The book of Revelation 17 verse 14. The Bible says, Revelation 17 verse 14. The Bible says, they will make war on the Lamb, and the Lamb will conquer them, for he is Lord of lords and the King of kings, and Lord and those who with him are called, chosen, and faithful. Yes, to crush the weapon, to crush the instrument of the wicked, is that the Lamb of God will conquer them. He's Lord of lords and the King of kings. So you do not be afraid. Use the Lord of use the Lamb. Use the Lord, use Jesus Christ. Use the Lamb of God. The Lamb of God, Jesus Christ, who is King of kings and Lord of lords, will conquer them, will destroy them, will crush their instrument, will crush their ways in the mighty name of Jesus. Jesus, the Son of God, will conquer them. The Lamb of God will conquer them and will destroy them, will crush their weapon, will crush their instrument into the bishops in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Because you are chosen a faithful. You are chosen a faithful one. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. Let's look at another scripture from the book of Job. Job 12, the Bible says, he frustrates the devices of the corrupt so that their hands achieve no success. God frustrates the devices of the corrupt. God will frustrate it. If you want to crush the weapon, the instrument of the wicked, you will frustrate them. If you frustrate them, they cannot able to operate. Because they will be confused. Even if you are a driver, very good driver, here is frustration that has followed you. You have been shaken. You have been frustrated to the end. It is very difficult even to drive. You cannot be driving effectively. Because your mind has been tortured, your mind has been striked, your mind has been crushed. So it will be very, even you can't see. Because you already your eyes will be blood. Yeah, your heart will be banking. with you babbling. So once you are frustrated, deep frustration, you can't think properly. You don't know the way. That is how the heaven will frustrate you. When the heaven will frustrate the instrument, or when the heaven will frustrate the instrument of the wickedness, they will not be able to operate. The heaven will crush them through frustrating. They will be crushed to pieces. So they can't think of anything to do. They can't remember anything. You can't do anything. Even if writing, you can't write even your name. Once you are deeply frustrated. That is how the power from heaven can crush the instrument of the wicked, the wickedness. Because the wickedness, they are evil and wicked. Now, the only thing to frustrate them and put a stop on them is to frustrate them so that they can, their hand cannot achieve anything. If they can make you not to achieve anything, you also, our Father, has power to make them not to achieve anything. It is the same thing. Remember, the wicked, they are frustrated. They make you not to achieve anything. Now it is your time to make them not to achieve anything. It is your time to rise up and crush their instrument and make sure that their hands are not achieving anything. They cannot succeed anything. That's how you can frustrate them. You make sure you close every windows, every door of the enemy by repenting, by asking God to forgive you, and anything that they will use against you, make sure that it gets out of your life. Now, it will give God permission to crush the instrument of the wicked through frustrating their devices, through frustrating their hands. Even God can cut their hands. God is able to chop the hands of the wicked, to frustrate them and lose their direction in Jesus' name. Yes, there's another scripture. It is from the book of Ephesians. The book of Ephesians, it says, 6 verse 14, the Bible says, "Stand therefore, hold your ground, having tightened the belt of truth around your waist, and having put the breastplate of integrity and of true goodness and right stand with God." The Bible said, "Stand firm therefore by fastening the belt of truth around your waist, by putting on the breastplate of righteousness." When you know how to stand firm, you stand firm. You will stand firm without being shaken. It will crush the demons. It will crush the instrument of the wicked. The wicked, they will not have power because you stand and fight and fastening the belt of the truth. When you know the truth will set you free. When you know the truth, no demon, no powers from the pit of hell will stand against you, will defeat you. When you know the truth, how to apply the word of God to the enemies will not have any power against you. Remember that you have been given power and authority. Therefore, every instrument of the wicked will not stand against you. You will crush them into pieces. When you stand your firm, stand firm and watch the instrument and command their instrument to be crushed by fire. You call the fire of God. You call the word of God. You command, you wicked person, hear the word of God. Every instrument you are using, I crush them. I crush them to pieces. You will not function. Even dreams. For example, you've been having terrible dreams and you don't know what to do about it. Use the fire of God. Ask the owner of those dreams. I am crushing these dreams to pieces. I am using the fire of God to burn them to ashes in the mighty name of Jesus. You crush their instrument. You know the instrument can be dreams. They can use dreams to molest you, to damage you, to torture you. So the best thing, if they are using the dreams to attack you and they infect you with the sickness, to defeat you, to disgrace you, you know, You can sometimes you see yourself in the dreams naked, or sometimes you see yourself naked people. Those are polluting. They are make you dirty so that God cannot use you. That is divided. They are dividing. That is seducing you. Now, when you see these dreams like this, you know they are using the dreams as their instrument to attack you. Crush it. Crush that dream. Command that dream to be crushed to pieces, because that is instrument they are using. They can use a instrument like wind. The wind can come and flow around you, and when they stop, they have put a witchcraft on you. They have put spells on. They have put anything sickness, evil in you. Some of you you have no idea. The wind they can be normal wind, but the satanic wind they would blow. Bro, when it reaches you, it is stopped on you. It doesn't go anywhere because it has done their mission. Now the wind, they are used. That is their instrument. Command that wind to stand still and obey. Command them. I command you to stand still, and I send you back to the sender. I destroy you. You will not function in my life, in Jesus' name. Even sometimes you can be driving, and then while you are driving, they can use an animal or anything in your vision. And then you try to brake. The moment you try to brake, you crash into pieces. That's how they are. So anytime you see a vision in your eyes like this, command that vision to crush it into pieces. The weapon of the enemy, you will have authority to cross it. You crush it into pieces. Don't let them to function. Remember what the Bible says in the book of Job. It says, "Do not let their hand to perform that to succeed. Let them be frustrated." Yes, that is what the Bible says. The Bible says in the book of Colossians 2 verse 15, God dismantled the principalities and the power that were arranged against us, and made bold display and a public example for them in trampling over them in him and in the cross. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. God himself has dismantled, God has crushed principalities and powers and wrenched against your life. And God is very clear here, saying, against us, which was against us. He has crushed their powers. He has dismantled them. He has destroyed them in the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, the Bible says in Colossians 2 verse 15, God disarmed the principalities and the powers that were arranged against us, and made bold display and public example of them in trembling over them in him and in the cross, in Jesus' name. God has already crushed them. So God has crushed every instrument of the wicked. So they have no power. They have no authority to work in your life, in Jesus' name. Here is the one, another scripture which says from 1 Timothy 6 verse 12. The Bible says, "Fight the good fight of the faith. Lay all on eternal life to which you were summoned, and for which you confess the good confession of faith before many witnesses." Fight a good fight. Fight a good fight of the faith. Fight a good one, not a bad one. Fight a good one. Crush them. Crush every instrument of the enemy. Crush them into pieces. That is how you can fight a good fight. Elisha fight a good fight because he made the enemies blind. When they were blind, they were not able to see. So he had to kill them, to destroy them, to do what they wanted. So when you know how to fight a good one, fight a good fight. You don't have to fight a great fight which would backfire and would destroy you. You fight a good one in the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, Lord. Father, I thank you. I thank you, Lord, because you are a God who has given us a hand, who has given us a weapon of fight, of war, that we will be able to fight a good fight in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord. I'm going to pray and God will help you. I'm going to pray that God will turn every works of the enemy against you, will go back and destroy themselves. God will stand against every wicked powers of darkness that is resting against you, shall be destroyed in Jesus' name. I'm going to pray that God will crush every weapon, every instrument of the enemy against your life and your children in the mighty name of Jesus. Every power assigned to turn your glory to shame, let them die. Let them die. Let them die. Every power assigned to turn your glory to shame, let them die. Let them die. Let them be destroyed in the mighty name of Jesus. I breathe the blood of Jesus. I am standing against every power assigned to turn your glory to shame, to be paralyzed, to be destroyed in the name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, Lord. Everything that must go for you to move forward, I command them to go by fire. In the name of Jesus. I am praying every instrument, every weapon of the enemy holding you backward. In the mighty name of Jesus. I command them, they must go. Let them go so that you can move forward. In the mighty name of Jesus. Anything standing, blocking you, any blockage of the enemy blocking your ways, let them be clear away in Jesus' name. In the mighty name of Jesus, I am praying that there are four people. I'm going to call them to get out of your way. They are holding. I am calling upon Cain. Cain is a jealous person. Cain, the spirit of Cain, that killed his brother because of offering. When you have a good offering, when you have good plans, when you want to serve God faithfully, there is a Cain spirit that is very jealous against you. When you are doing good, Cain is there who is very jealous. That spirit is the spirit of enemies and the jealousy. He doesn't want you to do anything good. Because of restlessness, Cain will appear and discourage you and make you not to think properly or not to do the work of God properly. Cain was jealous. Elode was the one who was killing people. Elode make the people of Israel, put the people of Israel in bondage. Pharaoh put the people, the children of Israel, in bondage. He made sure that you will not achieve, you will work, but you will not achieve anything. You will work like an elephant, but you will eat like an ant. You will work free. That is the spirit of Herod. That is the spirit of Pharaoh. The spirit of Pharaoh is the spirit that make you to work free. They don't care. They don't care. You will not be working free. You will work to be paid, and you will work to become wealthy. So this spirit of Pharaoh, they make you to work hard, to do two jobs, three jobs. You work so hard, but nothing you are bringing to the table. They make you a slave. That is the spirit of Pharaoh. I am commanding them to die. Every spirit of Pharaoh, every spirit of Cain, every spirit of Herod, they are the ones who kill visions, new infants. Anything good coming to you, they are there to kill you, to kill it. So, I am commanding the spirit of Herod to die in the mighty name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, the word of witchcraft attacking your star, I am cursing them. I command them to die, to be destroyed in Jesus' name. Every witchcraft words attacking your stars, attacking your stars. When they see you are shining, when they are seeing you are growing, they will come and attack you and destroy you. In the mighty name of Jesus, I command every witchcraft attack, every witchcraft words attacking your star, fall down and die in the name of Jesus. Yes, Lord, my Father, I plead the blood of Jesus. I am asking the angels of war to pursue those holding what belongs to you and command them to release them in the name of Jesus, in the mighty name of Jesus. Angels of war, arise and pursue those holding what belongs to you and command them to release them in the mighty name of Jesus, in the mighty name of Jesus. I'm calling the Lion of Judah, the Lion of Judah, roars, roar in the mighty name of Jesus, in the mighty name of Jesus. The Lion of Judah, roar, roar in the mighty name of Jesus. Every roaring lion that has vowed to devour you, you know the devil is called a lion, but it's not a lion. It's just roaring and they can't do you anything. But if you fear, you scare, he will do whatever he wants to do. But when you call the Lion of Judah to roar against the roar of the wicked lion of the devil, it will not go anywhere, because that the Lion of Judah will kill them. One Egyptian, they brought their witchcraft. They brought the rod and the rod of Moses. The rod of Moses swallowed their rod, so their witchcraft were powerless. They were not able to perform anything in Egypt. Now I pray that God will destroy every lion racing against you, every satanic lion racing, roaring against you. Let them be vanished and be destroyed in Jesus' name. Yes, Lord, my Father, in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, I want to thank you. I want to bless your name. I give you all the glory in the mighty name of Jesus. Every instrument of wickedness assigned against you, backfire in the name of Jesus. Be destroyed, be destroyed, be destroyed, be destroyed, be destroyed. Every instrument of wickedness assigned against you, be destroyed, be destroyed. Backfire and be destroyed. Backfire and be destroyed. Backfire and be destroyed in the name of Jesus. The seed of the enemy shall not bear fruits in the mighty name of Jesus. Every seed of the enemy shall not bear fruits against your life and your children. In Jesus' name, I destroy them. I command them to dry up from the roots. Any seeds the enemy is planting against you, I command them to die. I boil the blood of Jesus to kill them. It will not rise up. It will not function on you. It will not bear fruits in your life in the mighty name of Jesus. I cast them. I crush them. I destroy them. I bind them. I render them powerless. I am uprooting them from the roots. Let them die in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Yes, Lord. Thank you, Father. Satanic garment of wickedness, I command them to catch fire. Any satanic garment of wickedness, they come and put you while you are sleeping. You see garment coming very clearly. It come and wear you. And this garment, it's garment of disgrace, it's garment of poverty, it's garment of death. Therefore, I command every garment of witchcraft to catch fire and burn to ashes in the mighty name of Jesus. Any witchcraft power working against your blessings, I command them to die in the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, you are stolen oil. I command them, hear the word of the Lord, gather them back to your head in Jesus' name. Yes, Lord, my Father, I want to thank you, Jesus. I bless your name, God. Glorious Father, I call upon every stolen oil that has been taken away from your head to come back to your head again in Jesus' name. The anointing that has been taken away by the wicked, they have tried your anointing, they have taken away your anointing. I pray, let the anointing come back to your head back in the name of Jesus, in the mighty name of Jesus. Every power withholding your instrument of advancement, I command them to die. All evil powers holding your power or withholding in your instrument, let them die in the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, Lord, my Father, I want to thank you, Jesus. Lord Jesus, I bless your name, God. Every power withholding your instrument of advancement, I cast them. I command them to die. I destroy them. I cast them in the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, Lord, my Father. Every evil hand point at your destiny, whether in Jesus' name. Every evil hand pointing at your destiny, pointing at your progress, pointing at your workplace, pointing at your job, let them wither. You know, there's evil hand. There is evil. When they point at your business will dry up. You will lose customers. Every evil hand pointing at your business, pointing at your workplace, let it wither. Let those hands be withered. Let those hands be cut into pieces in the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, Lord, my Father, I pray that God Almighty, in the name of Jesus, every arrow of shame fired into your life, I command them to go back to the sender. Every arrows of shame that has been fired, you cannot be disgraced, you cannot be shamed. I destroy them, I bind them, I render them powerless in the mighty name of Jesus. Oh yes, Lord, my Father, every altar planning your demotion be dismantled by fire in the mighty name of Jesus. I destroy every evil altar, every satanic altar planning your demotion be dismantled by fire in the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, Lord, my Father, I want to thank you, God. I bleed the blood of Jesus. I call upon your name in the mighty name of Jesus. I pray, Father, in the name of Jesus, serpent and scorpion assigned to swallow your calling, I command them to die, 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 die. Serpent and scorpion assigned to swallow your calling, assigned to swallow your career, assigned to swallow your children, assigned to swallow your job, die by fire, die by fire. Be destroyed in the name of Jesus. Let the fire of God consume them. Let the fire of God burn them to ashes. They are serpent and scorpion that have been assigned against your business to swallow up your business, assigned against your career, assigned against your calling. When they come and they will mess up, they will take everything from you. I am calling fire. Fire! Burn them to ashes. Let them burn to ashes in Jesus' name. Where is the Lord God of Elijah? Let the God of Elijah divide your children by fire in the mighty name of Jesus. Where is the Lord God of Elijah? Let God arise and divide your children. When you want to go through anything you have been struggling, you want to move forward, but they said Jordan River. Let the God of Elijah divide that Jordan. Jordan is the blockage that they broke you. You cannot go through. Anywhere you want to go, you reach somewhere, there's a blockage, so you can't pass. I pray that Jordan River, let it be divided in Jesus' name. Jordan River is a blockage. When you want to go to breakthrough, when you want to pass to get something, the Jordan River is here. Now you don't know what to do. You can't go backward. You are stuck there until it is to be divided so that you can pass through. Let Jordan River be divided, be scattered in the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, Lord, my God. Voice speaking against you, raising up. Shut up. Every voices speaking against you, raising up. Speaking against you, raising up. You know there is evil voices speaking against your progress, speaking against your work, speaking against your career, speaking against what you are doing. They cannot talk good. They cannot appreciate. They are evil. They are thinking evil against you. You know they are watching you, and the voices is against you, speaking against you. Let those voices to be subjugated and not rise again in Jesus' name. Jehovah is the story changers. I ask because God is the story changer. God can change your story. God can change you from zero to hero. God can change you from grass to hero in the mighty name of Jesus. God can change you. God is a changer. God changes Joseph. God has changed people. Many people, when God changes you, your story will completely change. God changed a man called Bartimaeus, son of Demayo, who was a blind and a beggar. God changed the story of a beggar who used to stay in a beauty gate. When Peter and John look at the man was asking the money, but God changed his story, and the man never became again. I thank you that God who will change your story is the same God. He will change your story today. He will change your story today. It is not too late for God to change your story. He will change you and you will be a different person in the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, Lord, my Father, in the mighty name of Jesus. Power blind, strange battle. You are a liar. Die by fire. Die by fire in the mighty name of Jesus. Strange battle. People are going to battles. Battles everywhere. They don't know. They are struggling. They are fighting, and they don't know what they are fighting. Some people, they call me and say, I don't know what is going on. I can't explain why. They are battling. They are fighting. They are struggling everywhere. They have no idea. Let those stranger battle die. Let everything that is working against you die. Let every strange movement in your body to die. Let everything that is stolen in your life to be destroyed in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Powers delaying your blessings. Let them die. Let them die. Let them die. Every power delaying your blessings your blessings, holding your blessing, let them be destroyed. Let them be destroyed. Let them be destroyed. Let them render the powerless in the mighty name of Jesus. My God and my Father, I want to thank you, God. I bless your name. I give you the glory in the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, Lord, my Father, as this year is going to end, you shall not fall from grace in the mighty name of Jesus. As this month is going to end, it will end with the blessings. It will end with the blessings, and it will kill and die with every problem you have been facing in the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, Lord, I want to thank you. Oh Lord, you shall be surrounded by your God shall surround you by the war of fire throughout this year, throughout the next year, throughout the end of this month, in the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, Lord, the Lord will surround you throughout this week, remaining this week, in the mighty name of Jesus. God, I cover you with the fire of God around you and your family in Jesus' name. Yes, Lord. My Father, I want to thank you. I want to bless your name. I cover this prayer with the precious blood. I throw a wall of fire around this prayer. No one will be used to be attacked because of this prayer in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, I want to thank you. I bless your name. I give you all the glory. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I pray. Amen. Thank you very much. I have to stop here. God bless you. See you tonight, 9 p.m. Eastern Time. You can go to our website, www.overcomersdhministry.blogspot.ca. You can write to me, hallelujah, praise be the name of Jesus, overcomersdhm@gmail.com. Go to our website, go and donate, give me an offering. Go and donate to our ministry. If this ministry is blessing you, wherever you are in the world, you are listening to our ministry, and the ministry is blessing you, go and donate. Go and give me an offering in Jesus' name. I will pray for you. I will stand with you in Jesus' name. Thank you very much. This is your host, Prophetess Dr. Christine Isiki, saying bye-bye. See you tonight, 9 p.m., Periscope and Popcorn. Prayer line will be on. Thank you very much. God bless you. Have a wonderful day, time, and your time, evening. God bless you. Bye.